Oyster sanctuaries are built throughout the sounds of North Carolina, mostly in Pamlico Sound. There are about 15 of them currently in the state of North Carolina. And the idea is that they are these broodstock sanctuaries where we have adult oysters that spawn and reproduce and help to seed our wild oyster beds as well as our shellfish managed areas.
And so, more than 70 tons of granite will be used to construct a 50-acre oyster reef in Pamlico Sound. The stone is mined in North Carolina and loaded onto barges in Morehead City. It's the latest effort by the North Carolina Coastal Federation, as well as state and federal agencies, to restore oysters and oyster reefs to North Carolina's coastal waterways.
We're able to build 10 acres of oyster sanctuary, as well as some of the managed oyster areas around. They're called cult planting sites. So there will be 10 acres of the oyster sanctuary and about 40 acres of those managed oyster reefs that will eventually be open to harvest.
Pamlico Sound is roughly 80 miles long, 20 miles wide, and 20 to 25 feet deep. It is the largest sound on the East Coast. But look underwater.
What we're seeing on average at the sanctuary sites is about 1 million oysters per acre. So for every acre of oyster reef that we create, every acre of oyster sanctuary that's being built, we have about 1 million baby oysters on them.
Once a haven is built for the oysters to repopulate, Mother Nature does the rest in the spring and the fall once the water temperature hits 68 degrees.
So the idea is that these oyster sanctuaries are protected and the oysters produce, you know, adult oysters that then spawn, and their baby oysters then are floating around in the water. So once an oyster spawns, the baby oyster will float for about 2 weeks before it needs to find a place to settle. And so these sanctuaries are strategically located so that the currents help to distribute the oysters to these managed oyster beds as well as to the wild harvest areas.
There are 15 artificial oyster reefs scattered around Pamlico Sound. The Swan Island project is the newest and the largest.
We space them out in appropriate distances so that essentially whatever occurs on the site spills over into the adjoining sites. And essentially we develop this oyster network or sanctuary network, or some even are calling this oyster highway. It's this connectivity in all of our estuaries. The oysters become this complex three-dimensional structure on the bottom where fish and invertebrates and they all aggregate and come to that habitat. To grow, to eat, to seek refuge, and they just kind of all aggregate there.
The story goes that when European settlers first came to North Carolina, the sounds were so prolific with oysters that you could drop a gold coin in the water and see it go all the way down to the bottom of the sound, 26 feet down. That's how clear the water was with all of the oysters filtering the water. And there were oyster beds throughout the sounds. Over the years, they were harvested, and since then, oyster harvest has declined, partially because of the over-harvest, but also due to storms and disease and predation, as well as the habitat destruction that has occurred on the land and has an impact on our oysters in the sound.
About 250 acres of oyster reef have been built. The long-term goal is to double that and provide oysters a strong foundation on which to grow. The health of the coastal economy and coastal ecosystem depends on it.
Oysters are critically important to North Carolina. They're what's known as a keystone species.
Those oyster populations are important to maintaining water quality in the state. They maintain fish populations. They maintain recreational opportunities. They maintain those commercial opportunities.